guys, I'm Jacqueline. We're now here at Fangyuan Art Gallery. Here, it displays a lot of different kinds of artworks and also a lot of things that were left by our ancestors. So if you want to hear some history or some cool stories, follow me and let's go hear some cool stories. Hi everyone, this is Mr. Liao.
电视机前的各位观众们，大家好，欢迎各位来到方圆美术馆。方圆美术馆呢，成立到现在有10年了。那早期在1933年的时候，是我们当地第一个医生黄清武先生的家。那他除了当医生之外，后来也当我们将军乡的乡长，总共5任，所以他为在地这边帮助很多，也救了很多人。
After Mr. Huang Qingwu passed away, his offerings moved overseas, and the house was abandoned. In the end, it was sold to a construction company. A part of the house was demolished and was planned to be reconstructed as a service center for pre-sale house project. However, the local residents were grateful for Dr. Huang's contribution.And wanted to preserve the cultural relics in the house. They launched a movement to protect the building, and the pre-sale house project was terminated in the end. Dr. Huang's house was then bought and renovated by local businessman, Mr. Lin Zhengfeng, and then became the museum we see today.
So, as I mentioned, this house was the house of a doctor.And this room is where he used to work. And so here it displays a lot of different kinds of like prescriptions that he used to write or some really old books from the past. And there are also photos that captured the memories from the past.
Thanks to the efforts of local residents, Dr. Huang's house has been preserved. This is really a touching story.
有趣的是像这一位他的孙女还回来60几岁。
After she saw the photo with she and her grandfather in it, she bursted into tears. She's surprised that people are willing to help preserve all the memories about Dr. Huang, such as his stories, personal stuff, and a whole box of books in Japanese.
我们也很欢迎对日文有兴趣的可以来这边看。
The room displays items and manuscripts of Dr. Huang.Tourists get to read them closely. In addition, they can know more about Dr. Huang by reading the books that he once read here.
We are now in the exhibition rooms, and you can see here there are aisles right in the middle of the room. And there are also other rooms on both sides of this exhibition room, which means that this house is really, really big back in those days.
The exhibition space in Fangyuan Art Museum is divided into 3 parts. Aside from the permanent exhibition of Dr. Huang's personal items, there is a space for special exhibition and an exhibition room for relics of ordinary people. What's so special about this building is that all of the rooms are connected to each other.
This room where I'm standing now displays a lot of different kind of things and relics from the past. And so all these things you can see here have different kinds of meanings and the way they can use them.
Wow! This bed will surprise you! It used to be a gift for young people who were going to get married. It was specially made by a carpenter and took about 10 years to finish one. Can you guess?What a bucket here was for. It's a bucket to put newborn babies. Did you get it right? It's a tool used in delivery babies. Very special, indeed. By the way, why is this place named Fangyuan Art Museum?
他写了这些著作，你才发现，他就是把方跟圆为他生活的一个准则。
Dr. Huang aimed to be lenient with others and strict with himself. In this building, you will discover lots of rounds and angles that reflect his belief.
One special feature about the architecture here that I would like to mention is that this place is a mix of rounds and angles. So like for example, the arch and the pond, they are round, And the windows and the doors, they are totally with angles.
I came across Mr. Xie Mingqi at the museum. He told me that the metal framing roof installed with rivets was moved all the way here from Jiankang Road. It's worth seeing. The size of the roof perfectly fits the building.
If you enjoy immersing yourself in artistic atmosphere and also just to learn some history, you are very welcome to come to Fangyuan Art Gallery.